Ah, hello everybody, it's Megalithic here, and today we're going to take a look at purchasing the latest vehicle released by Rockstar as part of the Casino DLC. So why don't we go on inside, okie dokie, and here we go, heading on into the Maze Bank offices, ladies and gentlemen. And there we go, you can see them there, rather fetching, but it's rather plain building, really, I don't know what am I talking about. Anyway, here we go, going on up to my personal office now here, ladies and gentlemen, here we are now, I must warn you, ladies and gentlemen, don't speak to my secretary, she's a wretched woman. Caught her selling illegal whale and dolphin meat the other night, you know, absolutely shocking, absolutely appalling. Delicious, it has to be said, yes, absolutely, but still appalling behavior. Okay, then, now, we're going to sit on down now at the computer here, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go on and order this latest vehicle. Now, the Bravado Gauntlet Hellfire, ladies and gentlemen, can be found under the Southern San Andreas Super Auto site. And there we go, the Bravado Gauntlet Hellfire, retailing for a price of $745,000, ladies and gentlemen. And there we go, we see it looks quite striking in a red now, doesn't it? I might go for an orange, but I already had a gauntlet and orange, so I may as well go for a yellow on this occasion. Anything down there worth reading? I highly doubt it. Okay, and as always, we're going to send it to the Hillcrest residence, but I accidentally don't focus on what I'm doing and send it to the office garage, you know. But that's easily remedied in the edit, ladies and gentlemen. On this occasion, we'll be getting there in the Bravado Gauntlet Classic, don't you know? And this handles really rather poorly, don't you know? Yes, as you're going to get a little chance to see here. Yeah, it's shocking, really, isn't it? Absolutely. Okie dokie. Well, we can only hope that the new Gauntlet, ladies and gentlemen, handles a little bit better. You know, they are rather clumbersome and lumbering cars, you know, as muscle cars tend to be, in my opinion. If not in my opinion, it's a blasted fact. Right, anyway, okay, now here we go, sod off, Ron. Right, okay, so here we are, ladies and gentlemen, at Hillcrest Residence, and what do you know, there's the Hellfire waiting for us. I wonder how that got there. Right, okie dokie, ladies and gentlemen, so what do we think? Well, it's quite a nice-looking vehicle, isn't it, you know? Presumably based upon the Hellcat, you know? Clearly, one would assume that to be the case, of course. And it just looked rather fetching. I am rather taken by this vehicle, you know. Wouldn't mind owning one in real life if I was in a country the size of America. Of course, I'm not. I'm in Britain. So, in that case, we may do with a teacup or something like that sort. We just put wheels on that and drive around. Okay, but if I was in America, this is the sort of vehicle. Absolutely striking, you know. Fantastic vehicle. Okay, so let's take it on outside, ladies and gentlemen, onto the street, and we'll see how she handles, see how she performs. Right. Okay, not a good start, ladies and gentlemen. Right. Okay, got good off-road potential, though, hasn't it? Okay, absolutely shocking, ladies and gentlemen. Terrible acceleration in that corner, really was. Okay, let's give it some... Right, okay, here we go, trying to get around these corners. Right, okay, losing straight away, aren't I? And bloody hell, I had to come to a stop. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, well, this sort of is what we'd expect from the muscle car, you know, ladies and gentlemen, really is. Absolutely shocking, you know, they've got a lot of power, many of them, but absolutely awful acceleration, a good deal of them, and every single one of them has terrible handling, in my opinion. Okay, and this vehicle is no different, as you saw, really couldn't handle the bottom bit of the hill there, came right off, slid all the way off, and okay, well, we're on the main straight down here now, ladies and gentlemen, so we'll go in there, we'll go and give it a go, see what she can do. And it's not a great deal, is it? Okay, right, getting a little bit of speed, but it's certainly right. We'll go to City Cam, see if we make it a bit more interesting, and we're bound to hit something. Yes, of course we are. I've got absolutely no idea why I persist in trying to get away with that. Okie dokie, you figure if it ever works out, it'll look good one time, but it's not worth the 50 or 60 failed efforts now, is it? Okay, much like the Bravado Gauntlet, one could say. Yes, I mean, they've released what, three different versions of this vehicle now, and every single one of them has been a sack of pig shit. Let's be quite frank about things, ladies and gentlemen. This really is an absolutely horrendous vehicle straight out of the box, but we're going to take it on into the custom auto shop and see if we can't just improve the ride somewhat. So why don't we go ahead and do that right now? Okay, so here we go, going on inside into the custom auto shop, ladies and gentlemen, and doubtless my assistant will be there, my motor assistant, I should say, and there she is, and and we're going to be upgrading this vehicle now. Okay, and as always, ladies and gentlemen, we shall be going at double speed during this section of the video, just in order to hurry things along somewhat. You know, you don't want to be sat in here too long. And as it actually turns out, ladies and gentlemen, there are rather a lot of options in terms of aesthetic stylings that this particular vehicle does come with, don't you know? Not going to go for that, thank you very much. Okie dokie, but yes, like I say, it really does have quite a lot of options, to be quite frank with you. You can play around with it to your heart's content, really. Now, as it happens, I'm sort of more taken by the standard stock features of this particular vehicle, but my good friend Mr. Raccoon has already gone and purchased this vehicle, you know, and he's sort of gone for a bit of different stylistic elements, and we'll be able to compare that later on a little bit, maybe. Okie dokie, but for now, like I say, we're just going to go through, and look at this, some liveries as well. Always nice to see some liveries on a vehicle, I do feel. Okay, I don't often apply them myself, but some of the more subtle ones I do like to see if I can go for them, see if I can get away with them, you know? Okay, and here we are going through, like I say, some of the more aesthetic stylings. The roll cage there, not really aesthetic, far more functional, one would assume. Okie dokie, and skirts and whatnot, not really taken. No, I think I'll just stick to stock again. Okay, and we're on to the spoiler. That's a good sign, ladies and gentlemen. It means we're getting towards the end of this particular section of the video, and we can take the car out and give it another try, don't you know? Righty-o. Okay, so where are we? Okay, onto the colour, right, that really will be it. Oh, and how about that? Yes, two-tone colour, right, that really is rather nice. So, presumably then, ladies and gentlemen, what with the sort of two-tone colour there, ladies and gentlemen, and the liveries, one really can make a good go at styling and sort of personalising this vehicle to one's own specifications. And there we go. Now, as it happens, I've decided I'm going to go for an entire yellow on this vehicle. You know, like I say, I have a gauntlet in orange, I have one in white and one in blue. And so, yes, I think I'm going to go for a yellow on this one. But I'm just going to go through some of the different colours there to give you an idea of what options are available to you. And there we go, okie dokie. But like I say, it is going to go into a yellow for my particular version of this car. Okay, and I think I'm going to go for a little bit of livery. And yes, there we go. I think it was quite striking, to be quite frank with you. I'm going to go for that. Why not, you know? Okay, well, that's about it, ladies and gentlemen. Why don't we take it down back onto the street now and see how she handles with those modifications. Okay, here we go. Right, okay, straight off the, straight out of the box, or rather straight off the bat now, at least, anyway. Actually, that feels quite a considerable amount of, so quite a considerable improvement there, ladies and gentlemen. Yes, the acceleration didn't feel too bad. Let's see if it's done anything to the handling of the top speed. Right, okay, no, not really. All right, oh, bloody hell, right, yes, camera, I didn't cut out, actually stopped recording there, started, I had to restart it, rather a shame. Got into cine camera, surely not going to be stupid enough to do that again, and yes, I am, and you know how that's going to end, and here it is, yes, bang, okay. So, what do we think, ladies and gentlemen? Well, I'll be quite frank with you, not much, you know, acceleration, very poor. Top speed, can't really say yet, but wouldn't imagine it's that much. And the handling is absolutely awful. Feels very heavy, very sort of lumbering, you know, very clumbersome. And, yes, what you'd expect from a muscle car, really. Not entirely impressed. Now, of course, I would normally take it in here or take it on up to the track, but I do fancy giving it another go, you know. See, like I say, I'm not particularly proficient, right? Okay, yes, I don't allow that restart to make you to allow you to think, you know, that I had two or three attempts at this and kept just crashing into cars and failing on everyone. No, that was just a little glitch there. Don't you worry about that. Yes, like I say, so not particularly good with these muscle cars, ladies and gentlemen, so I thought I would give it another go, you know, but as you can see, even after a couple of attempts around the standard lap, I'm not having much more luck. Like I say, this car is very heavy. As you can see, it's sort of wallowing about all over the road. When you come to a corner like that, a sharp corner, you really have got to slow down dramatically, because the car's simply not going to make it around, you know. Okay, and sodding hell, right, couldn't get in front of him or behind him, could I? Bugger. Right, okay, well, never mind. Right, okay, and here we go, isn't it? Right, no, okay, only get around that one. Okay, jolly good. Right, okay, right, I'm gonna have to go on the inside of this guy. No, round the outside, and we're sliding off, and bloody hell. Right, okay, so there we go, ladies and gentlemen. Even I was trying the foot brake. Oh, sorry, hell, right, okay, let's pretend we didn't see that, shall we? Right, okay, rather shocking. Terribly sorry, sir. Yes, anyway, like I say, so yes, they're very sort of wallowing car, terrible handling, you know. And there's only one real question that remains now, ladies and gentlemen. Can't even get into the sodding garage. How about that? Right, yeah, so only one question remains now, ladies and gentlemen. How to handle around the track, you know, and that's what we're going to find out now. First things first, the Pravado Gauntlet Classic, ladies and gentlemen. Another vehicle released recently on the part of the Casino DLC, also available on the Southern San Andreas Super Autos, or whatever that site may be, you know. And as you can see, yes, okay, well, I suppose one would sort of hope to see that, really. This is a very old-style car, the Hellcat, or the Hellfire, I should say, is a very modern car, and an overpowered car, certainly, and, yes, that's exactly what we'd expect to see. Yes, the Hellfire there, absolutely demolishing the Gauntlet Classic. Okay, so, well, there we go. That's round one, ladies and gentlemen. Let's move on to the next contender, then, shall we? And we're going to go ahead and put it up against the standard Gauntlet. Here we go. So this is the Bravado Gauntlet versus the Bravado Gauntlet Hellfire. And bloody Hellfire, there we go, that's what you get for your money, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to do exactly as it did to the Gauntlet Classic there, and it's going to absolutely demolish it. Okie dokie, now try to get around the corner. As I say, ladies and gentlemen, not particularly okay with these vehicles, you know, can't really handle them particularly well. Don't think anyone really can, you know, shocking vehicles, in my opinion. But there we go, either way, ladies and gentlemen, the Hellfire has absolutely destroyed it, and that's the Gauntlet there, the standard Gauntlet, coming in way, way behind it. Okay then, well, let's move it on to the axis. Let's take a moment here to appreciate the aesthetic stylings, you know. It is a rather striking looking vehicle, you know. It's taken down the two other Gauntlets, so maybe it's got something about it, you know, ladies and gentlemen. Doesn't look very, very nice. We're going to start taking it a little bit more seriously, not a great deal. This is the Virgo or the Vigero or something along those lines, not entirely certain, ladies and gentlemen. Another muscle car, more in its own class, you know, not a million miles away in price range, I don't think. Could be wrong on that, I ought to watch my tongue, really, but there we go. Okie dokie, and here we go. Actually, as you can see, we're going having absolutely no... Whoops, a daisies, right, okay, saying no difficulty, now I'm all over the road, right, sodding hell, he's going to come past me, isn't he? Right, well, how about that, ladies and gentlemen? Even with an absolutely shocking corner where I drive horizontally across the track, yes, this Virgo isn't going to take... Oh, bloody hell, right, okie dokie, sodding hell. Right, okay, well, ladies and gentlemen, that really was rather embarrassing, and of course, normally we'd sort of try again and again, but to be quite frank, the sun's getting low in the sky, and we don't think there's a chance in hell that the Virgo's going to beat it, so we're going to put it up against the Blade. Now, it should be pointed out, ladies and gentlemen, that I'm entirely certain who makes this vehicle the Blade, you know, but we undertook this test under the assumption that it had been fully upgraded, and later on it turned out that Mr. Raccoon had in fact not upgraded the vehicle. We did run the test with the upgraded vehicle, and it was indeed much closer than what you're about to see. But the results were definitive, ladies and gentlemen. The Blade didn't stand a chance against this vehicle, you know. And I should, in fact, point out that's Mr. Raccoon driving all the other vehicles. He has a channel of his own. His name's the Bromby. If you look how his name's spelled, then you'll be able to go and find his channel on YouTube there. And why don't you go have a look at that? There we go, the Bromby right there, with a rather stylish arrival. Well, yes, jolly good Mr. Raccoon. Okay, now we're going to take things more seriously, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to bring out what Mr. Raccoon refers to as Big Daddy Z, the Pegassi Zentorno, ladies and gentlemen, one of our personal favourites here, and a very, very competitive car for their money, you know, $725,000 less than the Hellfire, and let's see how it stacks up then, shall we? Yes, that's about what we'd expect to see now, isn't it? Now, admittedly, ladies and gentlemen, I didn't take the best corner there, you know, but as you can see from the mini-map, there really is no question. Now, we did run this test a number of times, despite, like I say, the waning light there. And, yes, it did turn out every single time the Zentorno took it, you know. So, now there is only one more question, ladies and gentlemen. And that question is the GTO. That is the question, and this is the answer, as it will always seem to be for the time being anyway. Of course, if the Hellfire can't beat the Zentorno, it doesn't stand a chance in hell of beating the GTO. And so, this is what Mr. Raccoon and I have taken to referring to as the final match. Masquerade, don't you know? And there we go, as you can see, we've just got round the top of the track there, and Mr. Raccoon is almost coming off the bottom back straight there, and there we go, he's going to be crossing the line right about now, And I still haven't got off the back straight, really. Absolutely shocking. So there we go. And slam into him. There we go. That'll teach him, Mr. Raccoon. Okay, so there we go, ladies and gentlemen. The Bravado Gauntlet Hellfire. What do we think? Well, what do we think, Mr. Raccoon? Why don't you let the good ladies and gentlemen know? Yes, that's what we think, Raspberries. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I do hope you've enjoyed this video, and thank you for watching.